In physics, we use lots and lots of different numbers, different prefixes, if you like. So, you've probably already come across kilobytes, megabytes, gigabytes, but also we use kilometers, we use nanometers, we use centimeters, we use all these different numbers, and so we don't have to write them all out. A gigabyte, for example, is a very large number. A nanometer is a very small number. So we don't have to write out all these leading zeros or trailing zeros. What we do is we use prefixes. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to teach you a way to remember all the prefixes easily. How are we going to do that? Aliens. So, as before, I'm going to say the mem read, and I want you to repeat it with me afterwards. 9 green men know nothing except maybe my name. There we go. So now say it with me. 9 green men know nothing except maybe my name. And let's talk about what this actually means. We're going to start at the beginning. 9 green. Well, green, it's a capital G there, stands for giga, and it means 10 to the power of 9. So, if I have a gigabyte, that means I have 10 to the power of 9 bytes of space or information. That's how it begins. 9 green. Giga is times 10 to the power of 9. So, 9 green men. Again, first letter. Capital M for mega, and that means times 10 to the power of 6. 9 green men know K. It's a small k this time, and it means kilo, and that means times 10 to the power of 3. You've obviously already come across it with kilometers, kilobytes. You've come across megabytes, gigabytes. And what you're noticing is that these numbers tend to increase and decrease by 3. So we had times 10 to the 9 for giga, times 10 to the 6 for mega, times 10 to the power of 3 for kilo. And this generally works. There's only one exception to that that you come across and gets used in regular everyday life. And we'll tell you about that in a minute. So kilo was times 10 to the power of 3. 9 green men know nothing. No prefix. Times 10 to the power of 0. Because 10 to the power of 0 is 1. So no prefix necessary. It's just the value. 9 green men know nothing except. This was the exception. Except. E-X-C. That except. C is for centi. It's a small letter. We've already come across it with centimeters. That's times 10 to the power of negative 2. And that's the only exception to going up and down in levels of 3 for everyday physics units and prefixes. Okay, so here we go. 9 green men know nothing except maybe. That's a small m. And that stands for milli. We've come across it with millimeters. And that means times 10 to the power of negative 3. So milli. 9 green men know nothing except maybe my. And here we go, it's another M. But this time, its symbol isn't a little M. It's a funny shaped U. It's a U with a long line coming into it. Long curved line coming up to it. On the way in. And that is micro. And that is times 10 to the power of negative 6. So 9 green men know nothing except maybe my name. And N, lowercase n in this case, stands for nano. And that is times 10 to the power of negative 9. You come across often things like nanometers when you're dealing with the wavelength of light. So 9 green men know nothing except maybe my name. All right, that takes us all the way from giga, which is times 10 to the power of 9, all the way down to nano, which is times 10 to the power of negative 9. And just in case you're sitting there saying, you know what, that's not enough. I know this is good for this level, but I want to know about the next level. Fair enough. I'll tell you a way to remember that. Here we go. It's the 9 green men know nothing except maybe my name, perhaps. The, capital T, stands for tera. You've obviously come across that with things like terabytes. And that means, following our rules of 3, times 10 to the power of 12. So that's tera, and it's a capital T, and it means times 10 to the power of 12. So a terabyte is times 10 to the power of 12 bytes. The 9 green men know nothing except maybe my name, perhaps. And as we look at it, well, we know that nano is times 10 to the negative 9, using our rules that it goes up and down by 3, with one exception, then we already know that perhaps is multiplied by 10 to the power of negative 12. That's all it means, times 10 to the power of negative 12, and that little p stands for pico. So the 9 green men know nothing except maybe my name, perhaps. There we go. So now you've come up with a way to use aliens to remember everything you need to know about prefixes. Good job.